pure and impure pipes. So pipes can be categorized as either pure pipes and impure pipes. Pure pipes are immutable, that means not changeable. Whereas impure pipes are mutable, that means changeable. So what is pure pipe? A pure pipe will execute only when the input value or the input parameters are changed. That means only when the input changes, the pure pipe is going to execute. Not after that. Whereas to run a pipe independent of the condition which is applied for pure pipe, we need to set the pure property to false. So basically we have a pipe directive, right? That is pipe metadata, in which we are supposed to pass an object. There we'll have now one more additional property which we'll have to set it to false. Because impure pipe tracks all the changes, performance is poor, but what is the advantage? The changes will be reflected immediately. So let us see this with a proper example. So I'll go back to the same project, and here I would like to add a very simple pipe for demo purpose, that is join pipe. So join dot pipe dot ts. So I would like to write import pipe comma pipe transform from @ angular core. Then we should write a custom pipe. So pipe. And in custom pipe, we are going to provide an object. And that object will have, of course, name. I'll call it as join. And I would like to provide an extra property now, that is pure. And this time, I would like to first develop a pure pipe. So true. So now write the class join pipe. And join pipe implements pipe transform, and here we'll provide a method transform. What is that we want to transform? Something. And of course in return we would like to give string. So basically we want to actually transform an array and return a string. So here we can give array. And now we can say return value. How to convert an array to string? Array dot join, and we would like to separate by, let's say, comma. We want comma as a separator. That's it. A simple transform. Now what I would like to do is, in my component, I would like to develop an array. I mean, let's say we have an array in which we would provide some data. Let's say person 1, like that, person 2, and so on. Now this array I would like to transform and display. How to do that? We'll give you a HR and let us say array is ARR, and I would like to transform using join. But to demonstrate the change in this ARR, I would like to have here one input. Let's say type is text, and we'll simply give some reference text name. Let's have a button. When I click on the button, I would like to execute one function which is addItem. And to addItem, I would like to pass the value of the text box. Simple, that's it. And of course, add item is the text. just to have some new lines at the bottom. Now we need to write this function addItem. AddItem value, and this I would like to push it into the value is of type string. That value I would like to push it into ARR. So ARR dot push value. That's it. ARR. This we have to use. So every time I click on the button, I'm actually making changes to the array. And because it is a pure pipe, let us see what happens. Let's change this to any. Array is not allowed. We'll give it as any. So any array can be passed to it. Good enough. Oh, running in debug mode. Something went wrong. At the end of the expression, date of birth. Something is wrong here. Okay. This colon. I put extra colon there. So stop debugging. Run once again. Still the error is there. Pipe join could not be found. Yes, the mistake I have done is I have not included join pipe here. So unless I include in the declarations, I cannot make use of it. So where is join pipe? It's join pipe from dot slash join dot pipe. Now it should work fine. So stop debugging, continue again. So here you see right now array has only two elements. Now I type P3 add, it's not adding here. Actually P4, data is getting added into the array. But even though the array is changing, the pipe is not producing the parsed output. That's what is the limitation of pure pipe. A pure pipe will execute only when the input value or the input parameters are changed. So right now input value is not changing. So what we'll do now, we want this to change, this change to reflect. So the only change we'll make in the whole example is make the pipe as impure. Just change this to false. Now if I run this, the same program, stop debugging, run once again. Here I add now P3 and it will immediately reflect here. P4 reflect here. P5 it will keep adding. So that is basic difference between pure pipe and impure pipe. If you want the transformed value to reflect immediately, then go for pure false. But remember, the benefit of pure pipe is it is faster and applied only when required. Whereas impure pipe is going to be slower because in background lot of querying is happening, kind of polling is happening in background. That is the basic limitation of impure pipe. Performance is poor when compared to pure pipe because continuous tracking of changes is happening. Here people ask me a very frequent question. What exactly is the meaning of when the input value changes? When the input value, is the input value not changing now? Actually no. Right now we are having the same array into which we are pushing the data. What does input value changes means? The array itself changes. For example, this dot ARR, I'll now create a new array. Let's say in which I have A, B, C, and so on. And now let us change this to true. So are we changing the array? Yes, we are changing the array. Will the change in array reflect now? Let's see. If I just click on the button, ABC is coming here. This is change in the input. Even though it is pure, the change is immediately reflected. That is what precisely is the meaning of when the input value or input parameters are changed. Only then the pipe will come into the effect. Otherwise, pipe is not mutable. That means not changeable. So that's the precise meaning of it. So that's all. With this, we conclude the chapter pipes. Thank you.